Hello, today I'm going to make some dinner rolls in the Bellini, enough for two people. So it should turn out about four rolls, similar to the ones you can see in the front there. So the ingredients we require, 1 tablespoon or 5 grams of yeast, 1 tablespoon or 5 grams of caster sugar, 4.5 ounces or 140 grams of warm water, 7.5 ounces or 240 grams of flour, 1/2 teaspoon or 2.5 grams of salt, 1/2 tablespoon or 10 grams of olive oil, and an oven temperature of 400 degrees Fahrenheit or 200 degrees Celsius. As you can see, I've already measured what I require into these little containers, and the products that I'm using are just general products that are available at your local supermarket. So we'll see how that goes. For the first part of the method, we need to mix the yeast, sugar and water in a mixing jug. The water needs to be warm. I've used the scales that are supplied with the Bellini to measure that out. So let's have warm water. The yeast and the sugar. Okay, we need to set speed 4. Okay, now that needs to be left covered for 10 minutes until the mix is nice and frothy on the inside. So I'll switch the camera off and we'll be back in 10 minutes or so to see how that's gone. Okay, it's been about 10 minutes and I'm going to have a look to see how the yeast is going. So as you can see, that's started bubbling and frothing, so that's exactly what I'm looking for. So we're ready to proceed to the next step. Okay, the next step is to add the remaining ingredients. So we've got the salt, olive oil, set the Bellini to speed 6. For 10 seconds. So I'll start with 2 and then I'll see what it looks like. And then decide whether I need to do it any further. Okay, and I'll be back once that's done. So now the kneading process is finished and it's time to check to see if it's ready. So as you can see, that's kneaded quite well. I just need to turn that out into oil. Needs to sit in a nice warm place for about 45 minutes until it doubles in size. Okay, it's been about 45 minutes or so and we've had this sitting in the sun, and as you can see it's more than doubled in size. So the first thing to do is to punch down the air. So I need to use some flour. Decide what shape you want for your buns. If you want sausage roll type buns, the tray that I'm using here is a non-stick tray. If you have a tray that isn't non-stick, you will have to grease it or line it with some baking. So you need to have set your oven to 200 degrees Celsius. It's up to you how fancy you be with these. You can obviously make them in any shape that you desire. Okay, and they're ready for the oven. Okay, now I'm placing these in the oven. Some additional things you can do with these as well is you can glaze them with milk and egg or anything like that you want to try. The cooking time is between 20 and 30 minutes, so I'm going to set it for 20 minutes and see what they're like at the 20 minute mark. If they need a little bit more, sometimes they need a bit more to brown them up. So we'll be back in 20 minutes time to see how they've turned out.
Okay, the beeper's gone on our timer. So I'll grab them out and see how they've turned out. So they're looking nice and brown. Okay, so as you can see, they've turned out quite nice. They're nice and brown on top. Just slice one open. You can add extra ingredients to these if you like. Things like herbs or sesame seeds on top. They can also be frozen as well. These ones here are frozen. So they keep really well in the freezer when frozen. Best way to eat these, fresh out of the oven. Nice whack of butter on top. Okay, thanks for watching the video. Stay tuned for other videos that I might upload.